From the News Channel 5 Network, this is Out and About Today. Sponsored by the Tennessee Performing Arts Center.
Happy holidays. I'm Chuck Long, and thanks for joining us on Out and About Today. We're wrapping up the year with a look at highlights in LGBTQIA movies and TV. Fortunately, on-screen queer representation, easy for me to say, is up 2.8% from last year. Joining me in the discussion, my co-hosts Brent and Pam. Hard to believe we're at the end of another year. Good to see you both.
Good to see you.
I know. Good to see you too.
Happy holidays.
Yes. Happy holidays. Love this time of year.
I don't know what we're watching, but I hope you got Carol in there.
So... Didn't we do Carol like 3 years ago?
I was going to say, yeah, like three years ago.
It's just one of my favorites.
It is. Yeah. And we need, quite frankly, we need more movies like that,
yeah.
too. You know? I noticed that when I was putting this together, where there were a lot of gay male characters and all, but that's also why we have high school coming up in here, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, yes,
yeah.
exactly. I'm glad you noticed that. So we're going to be talking about, it's very interesting to me, we've had really a lot of representation on television and films. Have you been pleasantly surprised?
Yeah, I mean, surprised is one word, but I mean, we've been building up, you know, over time, and that's kind of nice to see. But it is pleasantly surprised is one word I guess we could use for sort of the romantic comedy genre that we've talked about and you've brought up many times, to see leads, to see Billy Eichner be a lead. That's been nice, to not just be the fun sidekick.
Right, right. What are you watching in the genre?
What am I watching? Well, I don't only watch gay things, and I do want to comment on that we have to have representation with so many hits we're taking in the real world. We have to be represented. I mean, in this state, you know, we're just off an election, mm-hmm. which I think we all feel decent about, right? It wasn't
right.
a crazy red wave that people talked about. But there's a lot of people that don't want us performing drag, and they don't want us having pride. And maybe a lot of people's not the right word, but we have to have this representation.
Right.
We exist. We're around. We're in
right.
every segment of the population.
And at one point, we were in all top 10 of the movies or sitcoms on Netflix. I remember talking about that.
Yeah.
I didn't see that.
Well,
yeah.
It was just a fleeting moment because, you know, those things change. But with Elite and a few of these other sort of foreign shows that have come in pre-dub.
Yeah.
Right, right. So it's nice to see us in the top 10 multiple times.
Yeah. All right. So let's get into this. We're going to take a look at a number of clips. This one is causing a lot of Oscar buzz. It's called The Inspection. It stars Jeremy Pope, big Broadway star. It's a true story. So we're going to take a look at it right now. This is The Inspection, and we'll talk about it on the backside.
If I die in this uniform, I'm a hero. Somebody.
Mocap is supposed to break you down.
I want to go home.
If we leave, they win.
Why is this weapon your best friend, recruit?
Because it's the thing that protects the Marine to my left and to my right, sir.
I could have left you at any doorstep.
I am never giving up on us.
All right, that is The Inspection. That was lead Jeremy Pope. He's getting a lot of Oscar buzz. So impressions, Pam?
It looks great. I want to see it. I think the... you know, his mom not being supportive, at least what I've read, because it's not out yet, right? This is upcoming. And then having to hide but wanting to also do something that makes everybody proud of you because you feel like maybe they're not. It looks very moving, and I'm interested for sure. I want to see it.
Same here. I love a military drama anyway, and especially when you add these on top of it. But because it is, it sort of shows that in a different way, that sort of commitment that you can be gay and still be committed and still care and still want to be a part of something like that. And it's not the preconceived notion that some people might think it could be.
Right. And it's that storyline, too, of he felt like nobody respected him, nobody liked him, and mm-hmm. the only way he was going
to
get that respect was to go into,
right,
you know,
prove
military.
It.
Right,
prove
right,
it, right.
Which you shouldn't have to do. But yeah, looks like a really good movie.
It does.
All right, this one is also getting a lot of Oscar buzz, especially for the lead, Brendan Fraser. So we were talking about this before we went on the air. But we're going to take a look at it right now. This one is called The Whale. It stars Brendan Fraser and Sadie Sink from Stranger Things. So take a look. We'll talk on the backside.
Yeah. people are amazing.
A lot of people talking about that. So storyline on that one is he's married. He leaves his family for another man. The other man dies soon thereafter. And then he goes on, because out of depression, to binge eat. And he goes up to 600 pounds. I read that Brendan Fraser even wore 300 pounds of prosthetics to play this part. So, Brent, I'll start with you. What do you think?
It's just seeing Brendan Fraser in this role, first of all, just is gripping, because, you know, we think back to him flying through the jungle, and I think about all of his past work. So I'm intrigued to see him in sort of this heavy hitting role. And like you said, that sort of the sort of storyline behind it is just almost gut wrenching. And I really do want to see it. I have a hard time lately watching sort of emotional movies, but I'm willing to give this one a try because I want to see his performance.
Bam, about 30 seconds in this segment. What's your impression?
I want to see it. I think the transformation is remarkable. It hits you in the gut. Gut-wrenching is what I was thinking, too. I love him. I loved him since Blast Off. Was that the movie where they're... where they're in the... who knows?
Well, IMDb. Yeah. We'll search.
Yeah, interested in that as well.
Okay, good deal. All right, well, we need to take a short break, but when we return, we're going back to high school and issuing a spoiler alert. You're watching Out and About Today.
Oh, sorry.